Hello, I'm Mr. True. Today we're going to take a look at solving some linear equations that you might see in an algebra or beginning of your Algebra 2 book. I've been doing a lot of these lately with one of my classes, and I just wanted to point out to you that if you take these five steps, you're not going to be able to solve all equations, especially as they become near your quadratic formulas and stuff like that, but they will get you through quite a few of the problems that you would have in an algebra or a beginning of an Algebra 2 book. So let's take a look at a couple of those and see how these steps help us out. First of all, we're going to have 3 minus 4 times, let's say x plus 2 equals 7. This equation has parentheses in it. You're not going to be able to solve for a variable if those parentheses are in the equation. So step one, if you have them, get rid of them. You're going to do that by taking the number that is right in front of the parentheses, touching it, and multiply or distribute it through the parentheses. It's going to look like this. 3, negative 4 times 1 is negative 4x, and negative 4 times positive 2 is negative 8 equals 7. I'm going to keep my work very, very neat and do one step at a time. If you're struggling in algebra and you get a lot of mistakes wrong or questions wrong from small sign errors, this will help a lot. Do one step at a time. Well, now it says add like terms. Those terms can have the same variable or the same number. If we're talking variables, make sure they also have the same exponent. This equation has a common like terms of negative 8 and positive 3. Those are going to come together, and the minus sign is for the 4, not the 8. So don't pay attention to that. The 3 is positive, the 8 is negative. 3 minus 8 is negative 5. So negative 4x minus 5 equals 7. We're going to continue to get this x alone that's on the right hand, on the left hand side. Every time you move something now, I'm going to start moving things over the equal sign or under the equal sign. Anytime you want to take a number over to the other side of the equation, you should be thinking the opposite function, do the opposite. This x has a 5 attached to it, and we're going to undo that subtraction with addition, the opposite operation. So we're going to add 5 to both sides and get negative 4x, equal sign coming straight down. 7 and 5 is 12. Now with the x, we have a negative 4. It's attached with multiplication. So we're going to undo that multiplication with division and get x is equal to negative 3. Done. If you want to check this work, if this is truly the answer, you should be able to, I'll do it with my red chalk to check the work, take this answer and plug it back into the original problem. A lot of us forget to do this or get lazy and they just skip it. But if you want to make sure the negative 3 is right, plug it back up into the original equation. 3 minus 4 times x we just found was negative 3. Negative 3 plus 2 parentheses equals 7. Woo! Parentheses. You got to work with those first. Inside the parentheses, negative 3 and positive 2, signs are different, so subtract those numbers and keep the sign of a larger number. That's going to be 3 minus 4 times negative 1 equals 7. Two negatives together when you multiply make a positive. So now we got 3 plus 4 equals 7, and guess what? It sure is. Now, let's take this check away for a second, not that we really need to, and focus in on this equation. Now, if this equation was an inequality, I'm going to change the example a little bit. If this were an inequality such as less than or greater than, or excuse me, less than or equal to. My mouth doesn't always say what I'm thinking. Whoa, I just made a mistake there. Because I was about to tell you that when you solve an inequality, you follow the exact same steps as you do an equation, and you do. But I got a little mistake in here somewhere. Where is it? When you divide by a negative number, this is the only difference when you deal with inequalities compared to equations. When you divide by a negative number, you've got to remember to come back up here and change the direction of that inequality. When I divided by that negative 4 and got negative 3, if it were an inequality, and now it is, you have to change the direction of that sign. That is the only difference between solving inequalities and solving equations. Let's take a look at a mistake that I see very, very often with students that are just starting off in algebra. I'm going to keep this equation almost the same, but I'm going to take the 4 out and replace it with just a straight minus sign. Now, in that case, a lot of students want to take this 3 and multiply it through the parentheses. Now, I'm not going to highlight that because that's not right. See, before there was a 4 there touching right against that left parentheses. Touching means multiplication. That says the 3 is subtracted to whatever's in the parentheses. So what is in there? What are we supposed to do with the negative sign? Well, there's a negative 1 there that doesn't have to be represented. We can just have the minus sign, but there really is like a multiplication of negative 1. And that negative 1 is what's going through the parentheses giving you this. 3 negative 1 times 1 is negative 1x. Negative 1 times positive 2 is negative 2 equals 7. Again, with the like terms, 3 minus 2 is 1, so negative x plus 1 equals 7. Bring the 1 over. Whenever you move something over the equal sign, you want to do that with the opposite function, and the opposite of addition was subtraction. We still have a minus in front of that x. That means it is not solved for yet. You get that negative 1 away by dividing, and when you're all done, if you thought it was a hard question, bam! Celebrate. Okay. So now, let's take a look at something else. Let's take a look at 2/3 x plus 1/5 x equals 10 plus 2 x. You're like, okay, whoa, I am no good at fractions. First of all, you do need to be good, but I'm going to show you just for now, if you have an equation with fractions and you do not want those there, you can get rid of them. A fraction bar means division. And if you don't have, or if you do have a division that you do not want, you can undo that division by multiplying. Do the opposite of whatever that math function is. Well, so I'm telling you that I'm going to multiply both sides of the equation by a number. Now, I can't just pick a number. I have to multiply by something that cancels out the 3, and I have to multiply by something that will cancel out the 5. I want to get rid of both of these. So 5, 3 doesn't go into 5. 10, multiples of 5. 10, 3 doesn't go into 10. 15. Yeah, 3 goes into 15. So I'm going to take 15, multiply both sides of the equation by this value. I'm going to show the work in case you're not very strong with fractions. And we'll cancel them later. 15 times 2 is 30 over 3x plus 15 times 1 is 15. Over 5x equals 15 times 10 is going to be 115. So hopefully I can keep doing this in my head. Plus 15 times 2 is 30x. I still have fractions, but not really. Because I multiply by 15, this will cancel out. 30 divided by 3 is 10. And 15 divided by 5 is equal to 3, now all my fractions are gone. And I just have whole number answers. So I'm going to add like terms, because if I do have like terms on the same side of the equal sign, equal signs break an equation up into two parts. We have 10 and 3 is 13. I'm just copying everything else down. I kind of moved my equal sign over. I don't like the fact I did that. So we have, once again, 13x equals 115 plus 30x. Now, when you solve an equation and you have a variable on both sides of the equation, you can put that x anywhere you want, left or right. But most textbooks keep the variable to the left. So you don't have to, but you might just want to always take the x that's on the right. And I'm going to move it over with subtraction. Why am I doing that? Because it's already positive. I want to undo that. That's going to cancel that 30 out. 13 minus 30 is 27, negative 27. let's try negative 17. X equals 115. And I'm going to divide both sides by negative 17 because it's still with the X and it's touching. So I'm going to divide both sides by negative 17. And X equals negative 115 over 17. And I'm sure if you made that a decimal, that would probably be okay. I think I'm out of time. Let me go check. Hello, I got about 5 minutes left. Let's take a look at this. This looks quite a bit different than my previous two examples. And I got a fraction on each side. If you have an equation with only one fraction on each side, you can solve that equation with cross multiplication. Well, okay, but what if you don't have just one fraction on each side? That looks a lot more complicated than the previous question I just had up here. Well, I can still look at these fraction bars like division because, well, they are. And I can still, like my last example, multiply both sides of my equation by something that will cancel both of those numbers out. So what number does 3 and 4 both go into? 4, 8, 12. Okay, so let's multiply the entire thing through by 12 and see what happens. Now this is a little bit more complicated than the other one. This left side is a big old fraction bar. Now there's two terms up here, but this fraction bar is holding those two terms together. It's one term. It's a grouping symbol, actually. So when I multiply by 12, I only have to do it once. So this is going to be 12 times x plus 2 over 3, and see, we're going to have a cancellation here in a minute, equals, same thing over here, one term and another term, even though there's a lot going on here, this is one term, so 12 times 4x minus 1 over 4 plus 2 times 12 is 24. I still have my fractions. I'm going to erase because, you know, I have limited space, but you might want to keep writing down on your paper. What's 12 divided by 3? 4. So take that out, make it 4. I don't need this fraction bar anymore. 12 divided by 4 is 3. So before I put the 12 through the parentheses, I'm able to cancel it with the bottom because it's in front of a parentheses like that. It's a factor. And then, of course, we still have the 24. This may look like more of your difficult questions at the end of an Algebra 1 book when you're first solving multiple step equations. Let's just take it one step at a time. You got parentheses, step 1, get rid of them. So 4 times 1x is 4x, 4 times 2 is 8, equals, again with the distributive property because there's a number in front of that parentheses. If there were division or an exponent, it would be a little more complicated, but there's not. So 3 times 4 is 12. 3 times negative 1 is negative 3, and 24. Okay, if you have like terms, put those together. Again, my like terms don't have variables. I probably should have done one like that, but we have a positive 3 and 24. Those will come together to make 21. So 4x plus 8 equals 12x plus 21. And again, I have a variable on both sides. Now, if you want to avoid negatives, take the small x and move it underneath the larger one and just make your movements so that you have a positive answer. If you're a student that really wants those x's on the left because you're more comfortable with it, well then subtract both sides by 12. I'm going to move the 4 though this time. So I'm going to subtract 4 over from the left and right hand side. I'm going to erase it though because I'm starting to run out of space. But I am going to move the 4 over with subtraction. So I'm going to get 8x equals, excuse me, that's an 8. 8 equals 12 minus 4 is 8x plus 21. How does that 21 go away from the x? How do I make that 21 go over to the left-hand side when it's already positive? You subtract it. So I'm going to subtract both sides by 21. And I guess I'm going to have to make some more room here anyway. So I'm going to bring this over and get, what is that, negative 12? 13? 13. So negative 13 equals 8x, and I have the x, still has an 8 with it, so I'm going to move that 8 away by doing the opposite of the math operation already here, which is multiplication, so I'm going to divide both sides by 8 and get negative 13 over 8 is my answer for x. Now remember, I'm going to be out of time, I can't show this, but if you want to make sure this actually works, you got to plug it back into the original problem and see if both sides match. Thank you very much.